Welcome to Tal Tutorials. This is the second part for the class 9 chapter of CBSE, that is gravitation, chapter number 10. So in this PPT we will be discussing mostly on thrust and pressure. So have you ever wondered why a camel can run in a desert easily, why an army tank weighing more than 1,000 tons rests upon a continuous chain, why a truck or a motor bus has wider tires, why cutting tools have sharp edges? In order to address this question and understand the phenomena involved, we request you to go to through two important things, that is thrust and pressure. Thrust is nothing, it is a force acting normally on the surface. See, if someone is pushing like this, that is thrust. Or you can say, if you are not familiar with term normal, you can say perpendicular. So whatever example I gave you before, weight is acting vertically downward. So the force is acting perpendicular to the surface or acting normally on the surface. This is the definition for the thrust, and its SI unit is Newton. When you stand on a loose sand, the force, that is your weight of your body, is acting on an area equal to area of your feet. When you lie down, the same force acts on an area equal to contact area of your whole body, which is larger than the area of your feet. Thus, the effect of the forces of the same magnitude on different area are different. So, thrust is same, but effect are different. So effect, that thrust effect is dependent on its area, and that effect of thrust on sand is larger while standing while lying. So thrust on unit area is defined as pressure. Pressure is equal to thrust by area. Okay. So pressure SI unit is Pascal. So pressure is the thrust per unit area of the surface, and pressure is defined as thrust by area, and its SI unit is Newton per meter square or Pascal. This is the pressure. Now, let us go further. What is pressure in fluid? To make you understand properly, all liquid and gases are fluid. A solid exerts pressure on the surface due to its rest. Similarly, fluids have weight, and they also exert pressure on the base and the wall of the container in which they are enclosed. Pressure exerted in any confined mass of fluid is transmitted undiminished in all directions. It is not in only one single direction. So, now we understand about the upthrust or buoyancy. See, when a body is partially or wholly immersed in a liquid, there is always an upward force which acts on it. This upward force is known as upthrust. Upthrust can be demonstrated by an experiment. See, what is that experiment? We take an empty can and close its mouth with an airtight stopper. We put it in a tube filled with water. It floats with a large part of it above the surface of the water and only a small part of it below the surface of water. We push the can into the water, you can feel an upward force and you find it difficult to push the can further into water. It is noticed that as the can is pushed more and more into the water, the more and more force is needed to push that can further into water until it is completely immersed. When a can is fully inside the water, a definite force is still needed to keep it at rest in that position. Again, if the can is released in that position, it is noticed that the can bounces back to the upward surface and that starts floating again. So buoyant force acts always on a body due to liquid acts upward at the center of buoyancy. Clear with this, huh? Now, what is Archimedes' principal state? See, Archimedes' principal state that when a body is immersed partially or completely in a liquid, it experiences an upthrust which is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced by it. This was said by a Greek scientist and proved by the Archimedes. Okay. You will find the example and experiment on page number 141 of your book. Now, what is relative density? See, relative density of a substance is the ratio of density of the substance to the density of water at 4 degrees centigrade. The density of substance is defined as the mass of the unit volume, correct? The unit of density is kg per meter cube. The density of a given substance under the specified conditions remains the same. Therefore, the density of a substance is one of its characteristic properties. It is different for different substances. For example, density of gold is 19300 kg meter per cube. However, with water, that is 1000 kg meter per cube. So, it is often convenient to express density of a substance when we compare. And that comparison itself is a relative density. Since the ratio of we are comparing with the ratio of two similar quantity, it will have no units. Now, when the object will float and when, what is the, see, I have given you example, the nail sinks. The force due to the gravitational attraction of the earth on the iron nail pull it downward. Therefore, there is an upthrust of water on the nail. When it pushes upward, but the downward force acting on the nail is greater than the upthrust of water on the nail, so it sinks. The cork float while the nail sinks, that happens because of the difference of the density. The density of substance is defined as a mass per unit volume. The density of cork is less than the density of water. This means that the upthrust of water on the cork is greater than the weight of the cork, so it starts floating. The density of an iron nail is more than the density of water. This means that the upthrust of the water on the iron nail is less than weight of the nail, so it sinks. Therefore, object of density less than that of liquid floats on liquid, and the object of density greater than that of liquid sinks in the liquid. So with this whole thing, what I understood, object having less than of that of liquid which they are immersed floats on the surface. But if the density of an object is more than the density of the liquid which is immersed, then it sinks in the liquid. So this is the difference between floating and sinking. For floating, the density should have less than of the liquid, and for sinking, the density should have more than the sinking. More than the liquid. So this is the end of the theoretical PPT. In the next PPT, and that will be the last PPT for this chapter, and that will be totally based on the numerical part. Till then, bye bye, good night.